At the same level as the safety risk. So the first ambition is this one. We also want to design optimized workstations, work situation, and to promote stable equipment and tools. I'll show you a little bit later what we can do on design for different equipment and tools, but it's part of our job is, as we talked earlier, about the requirements for the power tools. The idea for us is to evaluate every tool we can have on the market and to select the better one about the safety and the ergonomics way, to be sure that we will have the best tools and the safer tools for every worker, for workers in France, in UK, in Qatar, in Philippines, everywhere. So we check the tools and we select the best with the minimum requirements. And the third part is to optimize the work environment and reduce the associated constraints. So we work. We can work also, like we said earlier, about chemicals, about the dust, about the noise and everything. So we would work like this. We take ergonomics in the assessment of risk. We work on tools and design, and we optimize work environment. So about the key points in the health plan, we have six different points we can work on. The first is to assess and map workplace ergonomic risk. I will show you that. Then we capture and monitor ergonomic causes of health and safety events, like we talked earlier about accidents or occupational disease. We consider ergonomic criteria when choosing equipment, and we standardize, like we do with the power tools. We support workstation storage organization and implementation and related logistic flows improvement at construction sites. So we help with the best organization to avoid losing time or to work too much or to have too much heavy handling. And the fifth part is the training. So we have the training for decision makers, production, method teams. So we train them to do the ergonomics assessment when they will plan a work situation, when they will design a tool or anything like this. And for workers like you, we have some awareness campaign training for all our employees. So we can train everyone about ergonomics in the companies. And at the end, we have what we did this morning. We ensure the warm-up exercise before starting work. So about the first point, assess and map workplaces in workplaces ergonomic risk. What we would like to do at the end is to have a map of different items here, like vibration, workspaces, noise, painful postures, hazardous chemical agents. And the idea is to have a map and to know for every workstation in every company the level of safety and ergonomic risk. So at the end, we know on what we have to work, and we know the most difficult workstation, work situation, and we can work on this. Or in the other side, we know which ones are the less painful, the less tiring, and we can put people with disabilities on those works, on those workstations. So we have some kind of level of difficulty. We can have a level of difficulty for every task, and so we can manage the ergonomics risk. So we have an app with that. We designed an app for safety officers. We train them, and safety officers can go on the on the field, on the work site. They do the assessment with the app, and after they have a quotation for the 7 items, and it tells us if we are well, if we are in green, everything is okay. If we are in yellow, it's okay, the work station, the task is okay, but if we can improve, it would be nice to improve. If we are in red, it's difficult. We have to do something and to make some improvements. So with the help of ergonomists like me. And if we reach the black level, the level 4, it means that we should stop the work like this and to improve immediately. You see, the black means we have a high level of ergonomics risk. It's kind of intervention. It's kind of stop the work. Your life is not engaged, but your health and your body is in danger in this situation. So besides that, when we have the map, we can work, we have tools of motion capture, like in the cinema, and we can do assessment like this also. We put the captures on the people, and we film them with a camera, and we can see every movement of the task, every movement of the work, and we can control this, we can control it, and to know in which part is the most difficult, which part we have to change, and what is the real problem in this workstation. And also we are working to vary this with the virtual reality, so we can have a virtual environment, and we put some worker with the capture for the motion capture, and he will simulate his work, he will simulate the task in the virtual environment, and beside we can see him work, and we can see what's going wrong and what we need to improve in the workstation. While in design, so we can do the assessment very early. It's a very interesting technology. So about the capture and monitor ergonomic causes and health and safety events. So basically, it's following the figures and the numbers like we saw earlier, the numbers about accidents and occupational disease. And we have talked with occupational doctors. They gave us some general information about the health of the workers. And so, for example, we saw that one of our bigger problem was back pain and manual handling related back pain. So we decided to edit some kind of rule for manual handling. We said, okay, we have a problem of back pain. We have a problem with manual handling. So we'll make a rule to follow to have a better management of the manual handling. So for example, we have this rule we implemented in France and in international. We make a list of the tools and equipment and everything, materials and everything. If it's loaded under, if it weighs under 15 kilos, it's green, it's okay. I can carry it alone by myself. If it's between 15 and 25 kilos, it's heavy equipment. So caution, we have to. We can do it, but under condition, we try to mechanize it, we try to work with a colleague, we ask help for a colleague. We must avoid to handle it in stairs or on long trip, on longer ways. And above 25 kilos, we would like to avoid the manual handling. And we must have mechanical handling only. This is something we started last year on French work sites, And it's going well, and we are expecting to this to extend in all over the group and the company. The third one is to consider ergonomics criteria when choosing work equipment and standardize. The idea is to make sure that every equipment and tools are the best regarding safety and ergonomics. We want to make sure that the people, the person that will use this tool will be safe. It will be easy for him. Maybe he can have a gain of time during his work. So, for example, we work on the framework. Once we have the design of the framework, we say, okay, we keep this one, and everybody will work with this tool, this design tool, because in that case, we are sure that wherever we will work, they will have the same level of ergonomics and safety. So we work on different tools, like electric carrier here in some buildings in France, some tools to lift heavy metal pieces with a magnet. This one is called Lift Black. We work also with some technologies. So, as ergonomists, we work also, so you have here some examples of what we can see in France and over the world. So I work on the design of TBM, you know, for tunnels. So I work with the producing team and the manufacturer, the builder of the TBM. And we ask them, okay, tell me, give me the design, give me the environment, tell me what they will have to do. And my work is to check if everything is okay and if a human being can do this. My job is always to remind people that the task will be carried out by a human being. And the question is, a human being, can a human being do that? That's my job. So we have some, we work also on implementation for some workshops. This is a welding workshop, so we make sure we have safe pedestrian walkways. We have welding. We have isolated welding welding area. We have isolated and protected machine area and so on. Or we can, for example, work on the design of a stretching guide. So, like with the TBM, I asked them to show me the design and what will be the task, what the worker will have to do, and I try to picture the worker in the environment and say, okay, this will be okay, this is, he cannot go, he cannot reach here, and I work with the designers and the methods to find the best way. So when it will be in utilization, in use, we will have the best configuration and the best environment. The safer environment and the best way regarding ergonomics. So the first point was about organization. So we can help on the project. We can help them with the installation and all the plans. We can make assessment of all the moving on the site. We can follow the worker and be sure that we have the safer the safer way and the quicker way, the faster way to go to from a point A to point B. After we can help them in the layout and to find and to place all the storage area with mechanical handling and to assure we have a safe pedestrian ways, not crossing the machine ways. We also work on the handling plan. So basically, we ask, okay, what is the task? Where is it? Where is your storage? How do you go from A to B? What do you have to carry? And how you will do that? And after we say, okay, this is possible. This will be difficult. We have to plan to have these tools or this help and anything like this. And we also to gain some time. We can have some storage, some with some compartments like this. So it's better for you when you are looking for something. You don't lose time in searching inside your box or in your basket. So it helps us to facilitate the move and the work and to not to lose too much time in the moving, for example. I have some example pictures here about what I told you earlier about the weight identification. So we have the rules with the green is okay. It's not heavy load, I can carry by myself. I have the yellow one, I have to ask I have to be careful and to do it under conditions. And we have the red, it's only mechanical handling. So we use the color code on stickers, for example. So this is the first example. You can put the stickers on the load you will have to carry. But if you cannot put the sticker on the load because it doesn't fit well, or it will be outside long time, so it will disappear, or maybe you have too much pieces, so you can do it on the storage, so on the racks, on the shelves, in box. And if you cannot do it on the storage, we have a third way to do this. So we use some kind of signboards. We take pictures of the materials. We indicate the weight with the color code. And we can indicate the way to handle it, the best way to handle it. So on in your container or workshop, you can have a wall picture of your lifting gear, for example, and you can put it on the walls. Here is an example of good practice in France. So you have a storage area. So you have the main poster signboard with every materials with the name and the weight and the color code. And after, for each places of materials, you can have a specific signboard that indicate the weight and the way to carry the handling. So this was for the first point. The first point about the training. So first we have what we call the ergo training for decision makers. So this one is for production and effort teams and safety officer. The point of this is to give the basic information about ergonomics to them, the basic information, so they can take it. They can think about ergonomics when they will be designing tools or equipment, what situation. So they have all the information to design the best workstations. So it's on the training carried out on 2 days. We have a theoretical presentation and we have some games and some exercise to learn about ergonomics and to have the basics about ergonomics to apply to the design and for the workstations and the work sites. And besides that, we have for the workers what we call in France les ateliers de la santé, but it's in English I would say the health workshop. So it's carried out in the morning, and we have three kinds of workshops. We have one we call Live My Life. It's a game like in a movie or in a theater. Everyone switch the job. We have some t-shirts, and everyone switch the role, so the worker can be a safety officer, the foreman is worker and everything. And they have to exchange about one situation. We have this one, it's kind of a simulator of aging of the body. We put strength on articulations and heavy load on the body to simulate the aging of the body. So people can be aware of how they will feel in the future, when they will be older, and when the body will be used. And we have the third one, is some kind of games, logistics games to compare with when we are organized with every box, with with some paper that indicating the name of the school, and the other side you have the box where everything is every school inside, and the idea is to run a race. They have the same list of screws, and the first that managed to find all the screws won. So, in details, I can present to you quickly. So, we have, like I said, the hardware challenge. It's a kind of race. You have two participants, one here, one here. They have the same amount of equipment, so equipment we can find on working sites. One has to carry by hand, like him, so he takes everything in his arms. And the other has some trolley with a stacked box. And they face each other in a race with checkpoints. So we ask them, okay, you take everything, you go there, after there, okay, sorry, I forgot, you have to go there, you have to go there, you have to go back, and so on. So this is a race. And here the objective is to demonstrate the benefits of mechanization versus the manual handling. And we have a gain of productivity for less efforts. We can easily imagine that when you are running everywhere and when you have to carry out a large amount of tools and materials, you will take more time and you will be more tired at the end. So about my life, like I said to you, so we take a risk situation presented on a photo or by Gio, and the attendees are invited to change role, like I said, and to talk about this situation. So workers become engineers or foremen, safety officer can be foreman, management, and everything. The idea is to change the roles, and everyone has to live the life of the other. The objective here is to adopt another point of view, the different point of view of mine, of the one I have every day, to a better understanding of each other and the work of each other. And it's a good way for us to talk about important health and safety subjects. We select the pictures and the videos with some main subjects we want to talk about, like manual handling, like work at height, like silica dust exposure, power tools, and everything like this. So this one is quite funny. And at the end, you already know this one, is to ensure warm-up exercise before starting work, like you do every day and like we did this morning. Okay, thank you for attention for this.